Jay Haynes for the Film Sensei YouTube channel. Last week, I showed how to separate, rig up, and animate these battle warship guns using assets from Production Crate, as well as Blender and HitFilm Pro. In this tutorial, I will show you how to get those laser guns firing. This tutorial contains a time-stamped table of contents for your reference. If you have not watched last week's video on how to separate, rig up, and animate the turrets and guns, you will want to do that first. There is a link in the description below, and I will leave one in the upper right-hand corner as well. In addition, I will be providing a project file of the final finished lasers effect for my Patreon supporters. Please consider supporting me as it really helps me out and allows me to continue to bring you this content. To create the lasers, I will use the particle simulator found in HitFilm Pro. Dragging this into a new composite shot, I will open up the Controls tab. Under Emitters, Emitter, I will change the trajectory to cone, and twirling this open, I will adjust the Y rotation to 90 degrees and the radius to 0. This will ensure the lasers fire in the correct direction and with focus. Under Particle Systems, General, I will change the particles per second to 4. This reflects how many times the laser will shoot per second. You will want to keyframe this value to turn on and off the laser. Under Appearance, I will change the texture source to built-in and select Sparks Star from the texture drop-down menu. Make sure Billboard and Align to Motion are both checked on, and Intersect Layers is not. Below, make sure that the color source is birth color and the alpha source is birth alpha. Change the color to the color that you want the lasers to be. For this example, I will choose green. Under Movement, change the life of the particles to 5 seconds, the scale to 10%, and the speed to 1000. You may have to change the life of the particles up or down depending on your shot. Adding a new camera, I can now see how this laser is looking. Turning on the motion blur of the particle sim will elongate the lasers to look more like Star Wars. Leaving the motion blur off will make them look more like Star Trek photon torpedoes. For this example, I will leave motion blur on. Depending on the look that you are going for, you can also add some effects. Some good ideas would be to add glow effects, neon glow effects set to the same color as the laser color, and maybe even an inner glow effect to add a little more body to the core of the laser. Also, think about using super glow, as it is very versatile and can produce a great look. For this example, I used a neon glow with an intensity of 0.2, an expansion of 0, a radius of 63, and set the color to green. In addition, I added an inner glow effect where I upped the opacity to 1. I set the color to green for this effect as well. Now I will create a new point layer and make it 3D. I will rename this point Top Front Laser Source 1. Since there are two guns, I will duplicate this point and call it Top Front Laser Source 2. For the moment, I will move these off-center just a little bit. I will now rename the emitter in the particle sim Top Front Laser 1. Duplicate it and rename the duplicate to Top Front Laser 2. Lastly, under Shape, I will attach both laser emitters to their respective source points. Now I can copy these layers over to my warship composite shot. Going to a top view, I will zoom in on the top front turret tilt point. I will parent the laser source 1 point to that top front turret tilt point. Then under Transform Properties, I will reset the position. Now I can move this point to be located on the very tip of one of the guns. I will double check this from the side as well. Now I can do the exact same thing with the laser source 2-point, but put it on the tip of the other gun. Pressing play, I can now see how these lasers look. If I keyframe the movement of the guns and their base turret, I can see how the lasers are firing correctly. Make sure you set those keyframes to either smooth or manual bezier. Next week, I will add ambient spill lighting around the turret as well as light flares for firing. These are not as important in long distance shots, but up close, they sell the realism of these lasers. I'm Jay Haynes for the Film Sensei YouTube channel, and that is how you get those guns firing. Patreon supporters, don't forget to download your copy of this laser project file. Please do me a favor and like this video, share it with your friends, and subscribe to my channel for more content like this. Thanks for watching.